excited to host again this year here at UK, the International Society of Neurogastronomy Symposium. And we are funded by the National Institute of Health to provide stimulating thought and intellectual back and forth between neuroscientists, agricultural and food technology scientists, chefs and culinary professionals, and other food industry related professionals to really address neuroscience and brain behavior of flavor perception and what that means for human health and sustainability. So at the end of the day, if any of the work that we do here provides relief for a single patient or a caregiver for that patient, family members, or a student or trainee, for our under our mission of College of Medicine, then you know all the hard work is worthwhile. I was a high school assistant principal in Chicago for Chicago Public School System, and I was with that system in different roles for about 10 years, and I wanted to do something different and refreshing, and I always had an affinity for neurosciences, and I pursued that at a later day, later part of my life, and here I am. It would have to be double down from Joe Beef in Montreal. So I'm gonna get a lot of flack for saying this, as a matter of fact. It's deep fried foie gras, two patties with Canadian bacon in the middle, with I believe it's Gouda, and drizzled with Canadian pure maple syrup. I strongly discourage people from having that more than once every 6 months. This is not genetic. My father has a full head of hair. My mother has full head of hair, and my grandparents do too. Yeah. This is all from being a high school assistant principal. And then all the work that I'm doing now here at UK, I don't know if it's making any of the hair regrow, but at the end of the day, this is not a style. My kids, my family, friends, my wife, my kids, my parents, everything I do revolves around them. And if I'm able to contribute to society and, you know, bring some clinical relief or answer a diagnostic question for patients, I'm fortunate enough to be able to provide that for people. And I'm fortunate enough to be able to do that here at University of Kentucky, surrounded by very esteemed colleagues who are very supportive. But at the end of the day, all of that is so that I could be a good father.